It hit so fast and so hard, and it just wouldn't stop. It just kept coming and coming and coming.
And that was 7 weeks ago, just hours after Joplin, Missouri got leveled by an EF5 tornado. This week, the death toll hit 159 after another victim injured in that tornado died. In the hours after that tornado, News Channel 8's Eric Hansen and photojournalist Glenn Bierman headed to the middle of the devastation.
So, more than a month later, they headed back to see how the city and its residents are starting the recovery process.
The last time we were here, Joplin was in shock. 7 weeks later, reality has set in, a physically and mentally draining reality that stretches for miles.
Pick a direction.
There was no way to describe this.
And point a camera.
You can't really fathom it unless you see it, I think.
And you'll capture complete devastation. But you'll also fail miserably at portraying the enormity of the buzzsaw that ripped Joplin to shreds.
I don't really think there's any media format that can really prepare you for it.
See, I've never seen a war zone or anything like that, but it's basically one of the first things you think of is, you know, this is just mass destruction at its worst.
3/4 of a mile across, 22 miles long, flat. Rick Duncan was on the hospital's sixth floor when its walls started flying.
And when it did, it took us down the hallway of the hospital like you see drag cars sitting on drag strip.
St. John's is now abandoned, but in the parking lot...
It has the feel of a tent, it does.
A doctor who grew up in Jefferson, Iowa, is seeing patients in a field hospital eerily similar to a scene from MASH.
Probably space is the biggest thing. There's somebody almost always right on top of you, patients, ancillary staff. So you get very friendly with everybody here in the tent.
This maze of air-conditioned operating rooms, laptops, and portable equipment was up within a week.
Is this fun? No. Is this like working in our hospital across the street? Absolutely not. But people do it because it's the greater good.
See, we're just sitting in the hallway.
A mile away, Sean McCulley's mom lived on Iowa Avenue.
She just has an anxiety attack just even coming by and looking at it.
Her home's uninhabitable, but at least she knows where it is, unlike those a block away.
When you drive by, houses are completely gone, or there would be a wall standing.
Mechanical claws have been grabbing garbage every waking hour. There's 3 times more debris to clean up here than there was at the World Trade Center. Just living around this every day can weigh as heavy as a twisted school bus.
I mean, it's hard to even fathom. I mean, what has happened?
But tattered flags now dominate blocks that have been scraped bare. The school's marquee, where only the O and the P held on, now holds hope. And trees stripped bare 7 weeks ago are acting just like this community, determined to come back, even if it's not pretty.
What's happened has happened, and now we just have to make the best of it.
The next month here in the debris field will be nothing but bulldozing, clearing, and hauling away debris. Only then will the city allow homeowners to get building permits to begin the next chapter of their lives. In Joplin, Eric Hansen, News Channel 8, Iowa's News Leader.
While he was there, Eric took dozens of still photographs in Joplin, and you can find those at KCCI.com.
And several Iowans have been living in Joplin since this tornado hit. They are coordinating the volunteer response. Tomorrow night at 6, Eric will show us the impact they are having.